Hey guys.
Okay.
Hey guys. Hey. Wait, we need to show them.
Okay. I have to do like the whole like hi. Oh, like the
you just can't wait.
Like the hi.
Hi.
Welcome to us eating Greek food talking about.
This is the Allie and Brooke mukbang Greek addiction.
Greek addition. This is the mukbang Greek addiction. So this is gonna be a mukbang and we're eating a ton of Greek food.
Can we just look at how pretty this is?
So we have Greek salads, we have orzo, we have a fat thing of hummus, all this pita, and then we also got a pizza.
From a Greek place.
It's gonna be fine though.
All
right, so let's...
Oh, also, we got Ben and Jerry's.
We also have Ben and Jerry's in the freezer. That'll be later. We'll like update you guys on that later. So I'm gonna take a tad bit of this.
Some hummus.
And we just figured we're gonna just chat. We're gonna talk for a little bit. We're gonna see what comes up. I mean, the possibilities are truly endless, you know?
Okay. First topic. Honestly, I would like to talk about-
Wait. That like puts-
I know.
The Sabra one like to shame.
I don't know.
With the grocery store one, like that
is real.
That's like, you could drink that.
Mm-hmm.
Do people do that? No.
Allie?
Okay. First topic.
I want to talk about shoes. I want to talk about sneakers. Not shoes, sneakers. Because I feel like nowadays, sneakers are like huge. And
all the rage.
It was used to be just guys, but I feel like for girls now, it's so cool to have a dope pair of sneakers.
So I just bought new sneakers and I don't regret it because on StockX to find Jordans is like impossible. They're like $600 and I found these for $100 in the boys youth section of the mall, so I'm very impressed. Let me just get that. So this first pair, I could cry just looking at them again. Big fan, really excited. And then second pair,
insane.
Yeah, wow.
Like probably the best purchase of your life, not gonna lie.
No, but sneakers for girls now are a major fashion thing.
Like, it used to be
just like
whoever's the little Louis pouch, like really, like whoever has like
a Gucci belt,
an off-white keychain on their keys. Now I feel like
sneakers are
it's
such
just
a thing.
Sneakers, and I feel like I'm so okay with that.
And it's like you can't get away with,
and they're so much harder. Like if you actually get them, like. That just goes to show how much work you
put
the
effort in. I've been wanting Jordans for months, like almost a year, and I finally found ones that worked. So,
what about Finish Line?
I know.
Crazy.
Finish Line, get on it.
Next topic, what should we talk about?
Going back to school with Corona. Let's tackle it.
Okay.
Straight on. Like the majority of my friends, Brooke goes to real college.
I go to Syracuse University. It's gonna be weird. So I'm living in my sorority house next year. And it's gonna be weird because people that aren't living in, that are in my sorority, they're not even allowed in my house. They can't even go in.
Wow.
We can't go to different dorms. Like, I bet the dining halls is only gonna be like taped. Like you can't sit in there.
Wow.
It's gonna be insane and it's gonna be such a big change, and I feel so bad for those incoming freshmen.
Yeah, because they're not gonna experience.
They're
like,
not, and then when they actually, when thing is normal, like they're not even gonna know what to do.
Yeah,
like they have no social life.
Yeah.
Like that's the main. That's how you meet, by going out and at school. And I'm not saying like go out, like go drink. Just actually, just like going out though, and like having that, it like gives you a social life.
That's how you meet people.
And that's how you meet people. Also, rushing, and I don't even know what they're gonna do with rushing. Like,
yeah,
they can't have a bunch of girls in a house together like talking to people. Like
I mean, the city is gonna be way different.
Yeah, city's never gonna be the same.
Are you guys doing the thing that's like Thanksgiving you come home?
Yeah,
most schools are doing that. They're like all gonna come home at Thanksgiving and be online through Christmas break and then go back right in the spring.
Yeah,
which I think could be smart.
Well, we don't even know
if we well, I'm saying wow to Corona, but also to like the food.
I know. Can you hand me a slice?
Yeah,
so good.
Wow.
Oh, I hate tomatoes.
What?
I refuse to eat a raw tomato.
Oh my god, I'm gonna throw up.
Comment down below.
Do you eat tomatoes?
Do you like raw? Okay, I'm not saying tomato sauce. I obviously love that. But raw tomatoes. You either love them or hate them, and there's
no actually, that's there's really fair. No, I would eat a raw tomato whole.
That's just the taste, the consistency.
Incredible.
Stunning.
With salt, you're psycho.
I hate tomatoes, eats pizza.
No, but tomato sauce.
No, but it's, yeah, that's,
it's cooked, it's yeah, it's flavor. Different.
That's fair. Tomatoes is that kind of food that, like, when it's cooked, it's a different flavor.
Oh, it's completely different.
Wow. It's like a different flavor.
Yeah, ketchup, completely different flavor.
Mm-hmm. So wait, is ketchup technically red sauce?
But it's vinegar.
Oh.
You know?
Oh.
So like.
So no.
Mm-mm.
Okay. Big news.
Oh. You just caught on. Part one of what the future holds. And by the future, I mean next weekend. Or this upcoming weekend, but you'll see.
We are going to the lake. I'm like, the lake. We're going to Brooks Lake House next Friday. Mm-hmm. It's a golly gosh darn good time. The lake is beautiful. The house is literally on the lake. Brooke has a boat. It's so fun.
I want
to tan.
You need a jet ski. I need to teach you to jet ski.
Yeah, so lake should be lit.
Never say that again.
Okay. You guys are gonna see Michael and Chris again. They made an appearance in a previous vlog. And Michael and Chris are joining us at the lake.
It's gonna be fun.
Michael and Chris are like our right-hand men. Men?
Mm-hmm.
Our right-hand men. We love them. We're very close with them. We just have a great time together. We always laugh. We're always like living it up, doing something crazy.
Like Mike and Chris are the friends that you know are gonna be at your wedding. You
For
know?
Sure, 1,000%. Oh, I could like get really sad.
I know, but it's true.
Yeah.
Like I feel like once you graduate, you know who's gonna be in your life. And like you figure it out.
Mm-hmm.
People change.
Mm-hmm. That's a big one.
It's a life lesson.
People change after high school, and the people that you think you're gonna stay close with might not be. And then the people that you don't think you'll stay close with,
no,
totally resurface.
100%.
So moral of the story is don't burn bridges.
Mm-mm.
You never know what could happen in the future. You never know how someone could change or someone could try to approach you again.
Yep.
So.
That's so true.
Literally, this is gonna sound dumb, but like literally be kind to everyone because you never know who will come back into your life.
You also never know what they're going through.
No, and you don't know what like job interview you could walk into, and it could be the girl that you were like mean to in high school, or the girl that was like the guy that was mean to you. Like you have no idea how down the road the tables could turn. So that's definitely a big lesson I learned. But let's talk about lessons that we learned post high school graduation.
If I could talk to my old self,
just
graduated.
Yeah.
If I would talk to myself last summer, don't rely on other people, and like not everyone in high school that you're friends with, you're probably not gonna, unless you put the effort in, you're probably not gonna see them again. That's okay, because the people that are still in your life, those are the people that matter. I really looked at like back at my high school relationships and friendships. Some are just not worth losing, and some are worth keeping and fighting for.
It's also the kind of thing that like you go through high school seeing the same people every day for 4 years, and then once graduation happens, like you are no longer obligated to see those people ever again.
Mm-mm.
It is truly up to like the two of us to have been like, hey, haven't seen you in forever, let's talk
and like
let's hang out.
Allie and I reconnected in like
middle of quarantine.
Mm-hmm.
After not talking much throughout
I haven't
the
seen
of
her
school,
since graduation, and we're gonna be sophomores in college.
Yeah. Like, but it's because we made the effort to then be like, hey, how have you been? Can we hang out?
Yeah.
I got back to Jersey and I've seen Brooke like at least twice a week since I've been home. Don't rely on people. And also a big thing that I learned was friendship is a two-way street. It's not a one-sided effort, it's a two-sided effort, and those friends you will also discover post-grad, because you might be putting out for someone in a friendship that you might have and they might not be. You then take that and learn from it and either move on or bring it up to them and try to fix it. Friendship's two-way street, it's a big one.
It's very good.
So like getting into the juicy stuff about relationships and stuff, I've never necessarily addressed this on YouTube. Not that I was hiding anything, I just never came up. Like now that we're talking about it, about it. I had a boyfriend my freshman year of high school, and I like talked to people throughout high school. My old boyfriend and I had broken up. Yeah. I met someone when I got to school. We dated for a little while. The differences between dating someone in college versus dating someone in high school is huge. Once you're in college, you are your own person. You don't necessarily have rules that you live by.
You're like, starting over your life. It's a new
part of your life. And unless you're like going to school with a million of your friends, like even if you know one person.
Which you shouldn't, by the way. Yeah. I don't recommend you doing that.
Well, just because you should meet new people. But like at the end of the day, even if you're going to school with people you know from high school, like you're going to have new friends.
Mm-hmm.
So when you get to college and like you are trying to start relationships with someone, you're not in your parents' house like, can I have this person over? It's truly on you to do whatever you feel is right and safe and like good for that moment in time. So you have the freedom to like explore all of these different options because you're living your own life and you're on your own time. It's one of the like most beautiful things about college.
And take advantage of that.
Yeah, 100%. Do not limit yourself and like try new things. Obviously be safe and smart, but like know that college is a place for you to explore, learn, and grow. 100%. So I dated this guy for a little while when I was at school. I'm not gonna like sugarcoat it. Like it was pretty serious. I like fell pretty fast. I'm getting emotional. I never knew this. We were pretty serious for a little bit and we broke up post Christmas break. And since then I've not dated anyone. Also like quarantine happened, so that wasn't really an option, but what I'm trying to say is that you learn from every relationship you are in. I learned from the relationships I was in high school. I learned from this past relationship. It's all about how you react to things and about how you handle how you proceed with your life. So for me, post breakup, I got my life together. I decided I was gonna start a YouTube channel. Corona happened. I bought the camera and I was like, let's go. And I honestly think that if I hadn't been through that breakup, I might not have been here right now. Like
I probably wouldn't be with you right now.
You know, I have no idea what would have happened, but obviously everything happens for a reason. You will learn that as well. Biggest thing about dating in college, know what you want and don't settle for less. Moving forward. Brooke.
We do not want to talk about my past relationship.
Brooke's like, well.
You know that voice on TikTok that's like the, when you do the voice effect and it's like the, hold on, I gotta find it now.
Exactly. No.
Yes.
You know that voice effect on TikTok that sounds like this? This is exactly what I feel like you talk about when you talk about
that is so good. Oh, also, anybody that lives in New Jersey, Englewood, 10 out of 10, recommend you going.
Yeah, Englewood's super cute.
Mm-hmm.
That's where we got food from tonight. We talked a lot.
Yeah, we did talk about a lot. If this video gets 1 million views, then we'll tell you everything
I'll tell you my deepest, darkest secrets. No. But that's going to be all for today. I'm going to have a vlog coming up soon. Stay tuned for that. You can follow both Brooke and I down below. I will leave our Instagrams.
It's okay. You don't have to follow me.
Follow Brooke. Thanks. And yeah, that's going to be all for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, let me know what you want to see in the comments down below. Don't forget, why am I like,
down below? Like and subscribe.
Don't forget to subscribe, all that cute stuff. And I will talk to you guys.
Also, no, don't forget, comment if you like raw tomatoes or not.
Please comment and tell Brooke that she's wrong.
Interesting.
We love raw tomatoes on this vlog.